This is Johnny the Gangster with Viva Productions, King of Entertainment, one-stop shop for all your entertainment needs. We have DJ service for weddings, corporate, and private events. Thrill your guests with Vegas Nights Casino Party, Blackjack, Craps, Roulette, Poker, and more. We also have event photography and limousine service. Call Viva Productions, 206-542-5733, or find us at viva-productions.com. A little less conversation, a little more action, you got it. Call Johnny the Gangster, I'll make you a deal you can't refuse. Ladies and gentlemen, guys and dolls, cats and chicks, you're listening to Viva ENT, and this is your host, Johnny the Capo. I am here in the studio on this glorious day here in Seattle with my co-host, Mrs.
Nina Khan.
Mrs. Nina Khan. Nina, it's a pleasure to have you on the show today.
It's awesome to be here.
Awesome is right, and my great, fabulous producer, Mr.
It's Eric C.C. Ryder. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon,
and
Eric.
Right out of the gate, I've got a question for Nina, if you don't mind.
Sure.
Absolutely.
Nina, when when you get mad, do people say, uh-oh, look out, it's the wrath of Khan?
Oh, yeah.
You are so funny. I always say that to my kids. Don't make me mad because the wrath of Khan will come out.
Funny I thought as much. That. I'm sure you get that every day. But
I do, and I love it.
Good.
Yes, and it does apply.
But actually, in my meetings and stuff, I used to say it's not the wrath of the Khan. I am related to a Genghis Khan.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
no way.
Look out.
But I wish I was with Chaka Khan because that would be make me more wealthy, right?
Right.
Chaka Khan.
In today's dollars, sure.
Absolutely.
Chaka Khan, one of my favorite singers of all time. Just,
oh, yeah.
Just because you mentioned her. You know, we got a great show for you today. I hope I pronounced the guy's name right. It's an unusual name. It's Jerry Osborne has an interview with him today. Go ahead, Eric.
Thurl Ravenscroft, and this is something of a tribute to Thurl
right.
Today because this was recorded before you passed on, I believe.
Correct, and he just passed on recently. Ladies and gentlemen, every week on Viva ENT, we do bring you legendary performers from all the decades. And I believe the gentleman's name is
Thurl.
Thurl. Okay, cool. I was close. Anyway, the voice of Tony the Tiger. You know Tony the Tiger, Frosted Flakes?
Of course.
Oh, this is going to be great.
The guy's voice is all over Disneyland. He was a bass singer. He's got more credentials than, or as many credentials as any producer, singer-songwriter that we've had in the show in the past.
Wow.
He was with Elvis Presley in the 1962 movie.
Wow.
It happened at the World's Fair, which was filmed right here in Seattle. And I talked to Jerry Osborne today, and I was wondering why the Jordanaires weren't on that album. And they may have been on a couple cuts. But the Thurl's group, the Mellowmen, were his backup vocalist on that movie.
That's amazing because, you know, Thurl... Ravenscroft, known, it's fun to say his name, actually,
right.
And known for his voiceover work in a lot of films, but as you say, a talented singer, and probably his best well-known song is You're a Mean One, Mr. Grinch, from the How the Grinch Stole Christmas special.
Right.
The animated special from the 60s, and I think everybody knows that song.
Oh, yeah. And you're absolutely right. And he was on hits with Rosemary Clooney from back in those days, and then Elvis did have a hit record out of the movie It Happened at the World's Fair, One Broken Heart for Sale, which peaked at number 11. And the Mellowmen were his backup vocalist on that song.
Right on. Well, I can't wait to hear what Jerry Osborne has put together for us coming up in the second half of the show.
Yeah, and you know,
this is going to be a great interview.
It's absolutely going to be a great interview. And you know that this gentleman recently passed away. So I think it's been within the last 6 months or so. So it's nice to be able to have a tribute on him. And
Actually, he passed away around 11 years ago. But
no kidding.
That's still pretty recent.
How come I just
for guys
heard
like us?
I know.
You're missing the beat finally. No, just kidding.
Well, you know why I just heard about it? Because Jerry told me about it.
Yeah.
Recently, about 6 months ago.
Yeah. But and it's almost exactly 11
wow.
years ago.
Oh, wow. Well, anyway, it's great to do a tribute 11 years later.
You know, he was 91 years old when he passed on.
Oh, my
no
gosh.
So he
way.
Lived a very rich, full life.
Well, you know, it just goes to show that I say it all the time. When I was a kid, people that were in their 60s, 65, they look 65. To those days' standards.
Yeah.
Like, so maybe to these days' standards, they might have looked 85. Because people that are 65 now look much younger than back when I was a kid.
Hmm. Yeah, we're cutting down on smoking and stuff like that.
Bacon consumption.
Bacon consumption, yeah. Probably doing a little more exercise, I think. Yeah, it's starting to pay off.
My mom said to me one time, well, why did Grandpa pass away so early? Well, he had bacon every morning for breakfast.
That'll do it.
Yeah, pretty much did, I think. Yeah. So anyway, I want to thank last week's guest, Bob Miranda from The Happenings. What a great guest he is. And you know what, Eric? A fella that we've had on the show three times, Buzz Kaysen. I think the name might ring a bell to you.
Yeah, absolutely.
But Buzz is going to be in Seattle next Tuesday.
Oh, cool.
At a nightclub with his act. And he's invited you, and he's invited me and Brad to come and check him out. And he's going to be in Algona. And I'm going to look at my emails and check out the club he's going to be at. But I'm going to do my best to try to make it there. I think it's absolutely wonderful and marvelous. And here it is right here, Osborne Enterprises. Buzz Kaysen at the Royal Bear. And the address is 35731 West Valley Highway South, Algona, Washington. And, of course, you know he wrote Soldier of Love, that the Beatles recorded and Pearl Jam recorded.
Right.
Everlasting Love that U2 and Gloria Estefan recorded. So I'm going to be there just so I can get a picture with the guy. What the hell?
That's
it's
great.
Worth $1 million.
Yeah, he's been on our show like three times.
Absolutely.
And he's been involved with countless hit records and productions and so on and so
can
forth.
Can I join you?
Yeah, I would love you to have you join us.
I'll be all decked out with my jewelry. So
yeah. Yep, he probably think you're an Indian princess.
Absolutely, that's the whole idea.
So since we're talking about joining us, Lena, tell us about your company, your jewelry company, what you do, all the fascinating things with all that gorgeous jewelry that you have. And let me tell you, I personally love bling. And
you are my number one customer, so which I love.
Well, great. I'm glad.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
So Nina's Fashionista Jewelry is my company. And, of course, you're talking to the Nina, one and only, they say. So my jewelry business, I started about 3.5 years ago. And it's really a unique opportunity, I should say. I don't buy, like, a whole bunch where you can walk into a Target or a Macy or whatever, and you can see, you know, somebody walking down the street and wearing the same thing as you are. My stuff, I buy maybe 20 to 25, maybe 15, but it's one of a kind pieces that I have.
Correct.
They are from India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, and Turkey.
Lovely.
And most of them are gold plated on silver.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, I don't have any middle people in there. So my cost is really reasonable, so people can buy it and buy several of them and change it and look fabulous. My intentions for doing this is to make women look awesome. Bling, bling, that's what it's all about. Women looking good, you know what? They perform better. They do good. So
yes.
I say wake up in the morning. I used to be actually a business development manager for a large company. And my vendors would ask me, what do you do? And I said, hey, I wake up, I look good, I go out there, and I do my job. And most of my customers loved the fact that I was so dressed up and everything.
Right.
That made their day. So then, you know, that kind of, I took kind of that with me, and that's what I do. I don't work right now to like going to a company, but I have my own company, but it's no different. I wake up, I look good, I come down. I'm a walking model sometimes.
That's correct.
I could be walking on a plane that I did. Somebody liked my jewelry, and she's buying it off of me as I'm walking on the plane. How fun is that?
It can't be any more fun. And you know what? When I first came up to Seattle in 2000, because I'm from Vegas, and I noticed that the, I hope I say this right, but the average Seattle woman doesn't dress exactly like the way you do.
And
I miss the gals and the ladies on the streets dressing up. Fantastic. And, you know, one of the reasons, the first thing that attracted to me about my wife when I met her was the fact that she was a gorgeous dame.
Awesome.
She was a gorgeous chick. She was made up. She looked great. She dressed nice.
Nice.
You know, she didn't have the flannel shirts on. and not any offense to anybody that has a flannel shirt. But I'm just saying, I like that look. I'm used to that look from my Vegas years. And I think that the more you promote that look in our area, the more it will be contagious. What do you say?
But I have to tell you this. I appreciate you for saying just that.
Mm-hmm.
That is what it's all about. You know, I don't dress up to impress others. I do it for my husband and myself and everybody else admires me. That's all good. And I admire you because of that, too, because you come out and you appreciate your wife as well as appreciate beauty. And that is a beautiful thing. And that's my goal in my business. You know, I do a lot of bridal shows, and I've done that quite a few with you, is if somebody I see is struggling with money, I'll just give it away just because I want them to look good. You know, and that's the whole idea of my business is I want women to look gorgeous and feel special.
Very good, Nina.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure having you.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, it's a pleasure to have you on the show, and we're going to talk more about it.
Sure.
Real quick, before we go to commercial break, I want to talk about our Saturn Barter Club person of the week is Amanda Wong, Art of the Smiles. She's going to be my guest next week at 3 o'clock, actually. And she's going to tell you about how she did my implant. She's working on an implant with me, and I'm almost to the point where I'm going to get it probably in the next week and a half, as soon as I make an appointment. Quick commercial, and then we'll come back with the Elvis pick of the week, and we're going to try to get Jerry Osborne on the line. Nina, what a fantastic show we're having
it's
today.
It's a pleasure, and it's wonderful.
It's fantastico.
Attention business owners. Experience a new world of business with barter. The Saturn Barter Company, located in Tacoma, is one of the most beneficial business decisions you can make. Using Saturn Barter, you are able to sell your products or services to other members of the exchange. You can then use that credit you've built up from your sales to purchase the products or services you or your company needs from other companies within Saturn Barter, all without the use of cash. Contact and join Saturn Barter Club today, 253-212-9999. Or online at SaturnBarter.com.
Dr. Amanda Wong and the team at Art of the Smiles provides comprehensive dental services at affordable prices. Their convenient location in Federal Way and their extended hours fits the needs of both families and working professionals. Whether it's transforming your smile through some of their cosmetic therapies or simply having your teeth cleaned, Art of the Smiles provides individualized care plans that address your priorities and needs. Visit Art of the Smiles.com or call 253 253- 253-839-4048. That's 253-839-4048. For same-day scheduling. Most insurances accepted. From cosmetic procedures to implant placement, molar root canals treatment, or wisdom teeth extractions.
Brides, do you want your big day to be stress-free, perfect, and stay within your budget? Well, Brides Club has all the inside information to make your dream a reality. Go to bridesclub.com. That's bridesclub.com. See upcoming bridal shows and events, view wedding vendors and special offers. And don't miss The Spotlight, the premier online wedding magazine with valuable articles you can't afford to miss. Brides Club helps make your wedding stress-free and perfect. Go to bridesclub.com. Check out bridesclub.com.
Lights, camera, action. Capture those precious moments at your special event with 1,000 Words Events friendly, fun party services. Make your guests smile with a unique photo booth. Bring the celebration anywhere with a green screen. Enhance the mood with event lighting or pile them in an awesome VW photo bus. Our services provide lasting memories and unique party favors. After all, a picture's worth 1,000 words. See for yourself what we do at 1000wordsevents.com or call us at 253-380-2026. Let's make some memories. Online at 1000wordsevents.com or 253-380-2026.
Is your vehicle needing some attention? Take it over to Maddie's Tuning and Shoreline for fast, affordable car care. Trusted, professional, Maddie's services all makes and models and has been trusted in the Puget Sound for almost 60 years. Call Brian Maddie at 206-364-3347 or stop by his convenient location in Shoreline right on Aurora at 152nd. Maddie's Tuning. Call 206-364-3347. Trusted for almost 60 years to keep you safe and on the road.
Life's a celebration. Grand Event Rentals makes your event their top priority. They are your full-service special event and party rental provider, supplying everything you need from start to finish. Their professional sales team and event staff work with you to create your dream event. With every event, Grand Event Rentals customers' needs are the most important. Whether you're planning an intimate outdoor wedding or an elaborate black tie gala, the Grand Event Rental specialists make great pride in providing our event planning experience to help create an unforgettable event. Please go and visit the Bellevue Showroom, Grand Event Rentals, or make a one-on-one appointment. Talk to them. They're trained, they're knowledgeable, they're event specialists, and they are going to take you through step-by-step everything that you need to make your day a success. Call Grand Event Rentals. Their number is 425-462-7368 or go to grandeventrentalswa.com.
Clay Radio, your conversation station. KLAY Lakewood Tacoma on 1180 AM.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. You're listening to Viva ENT. We have a fantastic guest on the half hour, Thurl Ravenscroft.
Croft,
that's close. You don't get much closer than that. Ravenscroft, Ravensholt. Anyway, I'm here in the studio with my co-host, Mrs.
Nina Khan, the one and only.
The one and only Nina Khan. And you know, I love having Nina on the show because she reminds me of myself.
You're the male version of me and I'm the female version of you.
Well, yeah, maybe. But I'm saying like she's full of personality.
And she's a much snappier dresser than you, though, Johnny. Sorry.
You know, I know.
I hope so.
I know. I don't even have no jewelry on or nothing.
I'm sure when you're on the stage, though, you're decked to the nines. Well,
I have to work on that one, huh?
You better believe it. And my fabulous producer, Mr.
This is Eric C.C. Ryder with you.
Eric C.C. Ryder. So, we have a little bit of time left. We have Jerry Osborne on the line now.
We do.
Okay. He's here.
Say hi, Jerry. Okay, Jerry. I want to talk a little bit before Thurl comes on, and I hope I said his name right this time. I'm sure I did. About it, the movie that happened at the World's Fair, because it was a Seattle movie, and Eric's going to play a little snippet of a happy ending, which was the ending clip of the movie right now. And then the Mellowmen And Thurl was on this clip, for God's sakes.
Wherever the Mellowmen were, Thurl was there. He's the one who founded that group, and so he was the leader of the group. So he's there wherever they are.
I'm telling you. So a little bit of one of my favorite tunes from the album.
Happy ending.
Happy ending. Give me a story with a happy ending. When boy meets girl to them, they never part again, but live forever happily, like you and me. Hard luck stories get me so upset, like Romeo and Juliet. I'm not smart enough to figure why some folks enjoy a real good cry. Happy ending, happy ending. Give me a story with a happy ending. When boy meets girl and then they never part again, but live forever happily.
I'm pretty sure, I don't know for sure if the Mellowmen were on that track or not. Jerry, you'd know better than I. We'd probably have to look it up. But definitely a great little tune for that movie.
Well, another good one that they are on is They Remind Me Too Much of You.
Oh, that's a beautiful song.
That's
a beautiful song, yeah.
And by the way, Johnny, just for you, we'll have Thurl talking about the history of his name, where it comes from and what it means. So listen carefully, and he will explain this to you because he knows you can't remember it.
Especially for a guy like me that has a good memory, but it's short.
He's going to be talking to you, my friend.
Very good. So tell us about your recollection. I'm trying to get that word out. I won't even say it.
Recollections.
Thank you so much. he helps me a lot.
If he can recollect.
He helps me a lot on the radio. We went through a whole thing about the Royal Philharmonic Band.
The Royal Philharmonic Orchestra.
Right. Yeah. Anyway, tell us about your knowledge about It Happened at the World's Fair, 1962 movie.
Well, it was unusual in that not very many films were made on location. I mean, most of them were done at the studios. So for them to come to Seattle, which quite frankly is the only way to get the point across that it was the World's Fair, but anyway, that was unusual at the time. So that right there was something that was different. Some of it was done back at the studio at MGM in Culver City, too. But it was a big deal in Seattle at the time, and there were people who went to the fair just to see him and hope that they see him or get a photo with him. Wow. And a lot of people did. I had a good friend who was standing next to him at the top of the Space Needle when they were filming the scene of I'm Falling in Love Tonight that he was singing to his co-star.
Gorgeous song.
And so, you know, the public was allowed to be around him when this was going on as opposed to being cordoned off or something like that.
Yeah.
I might want to add that was Kurt Russell's movie debut.
Well, he kicked him in the shins.
Right. You know, I love that Elvis, I don't know what you want to call it, flirting with the girl, being a ham, being that whole segment with him flirting with the nurse and then going to get himself kicked in the leg so he can go back and
well,
see her again.
Well, that was to give him a good cause to go see the nurse.
Yeah.
That's right. That's exactly right. Joan O'Brien. Joan O'Brien was the co-star on that movie.
Yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm. And, yeah, I think the movie was a great little movie. It was a great family-type movie. And at one time, Rolling Stone magazine called it the worst rock and roll movie of all time.
Well, I don't even think of it as a rock and roll movie. I think of it as a comedy, which all of the major stars did, and they all did movies that were perhaps not really complex or exciting scripts, but they were just good, enjoyable movies. And people sometimes pick on Elvis for doing movies like that, but all of the big stars did. I mean, you can look at Dean Martin, Frank Sinatra, Marlon Brando. Everybody did those kind of movies, so it isn't just him.
Yeah, and you're right about that. What I'm trying to think of real quick is I like the term musical comedy.
Well, that's what they were.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It was a musical comedy, It wasn't a dramatic film. It wasn't a rock and roll movie. It was a musical comedy.
MGM made their career with musicals, most of which were musical comedies.
That's correct, sir.
Well, you know, guys, this is a great discussion, but, you know, we've got to get into this Thurl Ravenscroft interview that Jerry put together for us here.
Thank you so much.
In just about a minute. And I know, Jerry, that you wanted to say something about this to set it up before we got into it.
Well, the only thing, of course, that we should mention is, as you talked about in a little earlier in the show, is that he died 11 years ago, so obviously he can't be with us today. But at the time this interview was made, he was absolutely remarkable with his memory of all the details of his life and his career and everything that he did that most people don't even know about, but they will if they listen close to the show today. And I have to say, there may not be a person whose voice has been heard by more people than Thurl Ravenscroft.
Incredible.
And that's partly because of all the people that go to any Disney park anywhere in the world. You still hear him today on all the different attractions and the rides and so forth. So he will introduce himself after I briefly introduce him and sort of repeat a little bit of what we've been talking about. But that's pretty much all it takes, because he is on autopilot once he introduces himself. He just rolls on from there, and I provide the music here and there just to embellish.
Okay, right. I'm going to sign off. Ladies and gentlemen, Buzz Kaysen next Tuesday night, May 24th at the Royal Bear. Thank you, Mr. Eric C.C. Ryder. Thank you, Nina Khan, for being our co-host today.
Thank you for having me.
We'll take you now and see you later, but stick on for Mr. Jerry Osborne.
Yes, indeed. More Viva ENT coming up next week, and stay tuned for this.
Thurl Ravenscroft has one of the most frequently heard voices in history. You'll find his bass voice on recordings by Rosemary Clooney, Georgia Gibbs, Elvis Presley, and many others. He's also heard on countless radio and TV commercials and is heard constantly by people visiting Disneyland or other Disney theme parks. We'll start with Rosemary Clooney's big hit from 1953, This Old House, and you'll hear Thurl prominently delivering his part.
This old house once knew his children, this old house once knew his wife. This old house was home and comfort as they fought the storms of life. This old house once rang with laughter, this old house heard many shouts. Now he trembles in the darkness when the lightning walks about.
Ain't you gonna need this house no longer, ain't you gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time to fix the shingles, ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges, nor to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer, he's a-getting ready to meet the saints. This old house is a-getting shaky, this old house is a-getting old. This old house lets in the rain, this old house lets in the cold. Oh, his knees are a-getting chilly, but he feels no fear of pain, 'cause he sees an angel peeking through a broken window pane.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer, ain't gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time to fix the shingles, ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges, nor to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer, he's a-getting ready to meet the saints. Afraid of thunder, this old house is afraid of storms. This old house just groans and trembles when the night wind flings its arms. This old house is a-getting feeble, this old house is a-needing paint. Just like him, it's tuckered out, but he's a-getting ready to meet the saints.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer, ain't gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time to fix the shingles, ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges, nor to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer, he's a-getting ready to meet the saints.
Ready to meet the saints.
Next, at the dawn of rock and roll, we find Thurl Ravenscroft doing the bass man work for Georgia Gibbs and her huge hit, Dance With Me, Henry.
Hey, baby, what do I have to do to make a hit with you.
You gotta dance with me, Henry.
All right, baby.
Dance with me, Henry.
Don't be maybe.
Rock with me, Henry.
Any old time.
Talk to me, Henry.
Don't change your mind.
Dance with me, Henry.
All right.
You better dance while the music goes on. Roll on, roll on, roll on while the cats are bawling.
Roll on, roll on.
You better stop your stalling.
Roll on, roll on.
It's intermission in a minute.
Roll on, roll on.
So you better get with it.
Roll on, roll on.
Dance with me, Henry. You better dance while the music goes on. Roll on, roll on, roll on. Henry, you ain't moving me. You better feel that boogie beat and get the lead out of your feet. You gotta dance with me, Henry.
Recordings that feature Thurl as the bass man do not credit him at all, so we didn't find out who this familiar voice was until years later. Well, now we know him, and he'll introduce himself.
My name is Ravenscroft, and a lady in Denver married a Dr. Ravenscroft, and she became intrigued with the name, so she decided to do some research. So she became so involved that she went over to England and stayed for several months tracing the family. And they traced it clear back to William the Conqueror, that far. And Ravenscroft merely means blackbird's home. That's all. The croft is a home and ravens are birds. Ravenscroft is blackbird's home. Traced back to William the Conqueror. And my first job was as a bass singer in the Goose Creek Quartet at the Country Church of Hollywood. That led to the Sportsman Quartet with Jack Benny and Eddie Cantor and Judy Canova. We were quite popular at that time. And then I formed a new quartet, the Mellowmen.
I'd like to trade my heart for a paper valentine.
A heart you couldn't break. A heart that wouldn't ache.
A heart that wouldn't worry about you anymore. They sell them by the dozen in the 5 and 10 cent store.
I read each paper heart, and then the teardrops start. I love you seems to be the favorite line. You broke my heart in two. It meant nothing more to you than just a paper valentine.
I'd like to trade my heart for a paper valentine. A heart you couldn't break, a heart that wouldn't ache, a heart that wouldn't worry about you anymore. They sell them by the dozen in the 5 and 10 cent store. I read each paper heart,
rock stars. I love you seems to be the favorite line. You broke my heart in two. It meant nothing more to you than just a paper valentine.
We were immediately accepted, and that one thing led to another.
Yes, it certainly did. And one of those other things was having the Mellowmen back Elvis on his recording session for the soundtrack of It Happened at the World's Fair. Now, if you listen closely, you'll hear Thurl Ravenscroft right there with Elvis.
Who wants to buy a heart? Oh, yeah. One broken lover's heart. Mm-hmm. One broken heart for sale.
Well, excuse me if you see me crying like a baby. Since she rejected me, there's nothing left to say to me.
Who wants to buy a heart? Oh, yeah. One broken lover's heart. One broken heart for sale.
Excuse me.
Okay, Al?
Would you just play that much back? I want to hear something.
Right. Sing,
please.
Here we go.
Okay.
Here we go. We're rolling.
I'm running out of breath.
We're rolling.
Okay.
Broken heart for sale. Take two.
One, two.
Who wants to buy a heart? Oh, yeah. One broken lover's heart. One broken heart for sale. Well, excuse me if you see me crying like a baby. Since she rejected me, there's nothing left to save me. Who wants to buy a heart? Oh, yeah, one broken lover's heart. One broken heart for sale. Hey, Cupid, where are you? My heart is growing sadder. That girl rejected me just when I thought I had her. Who wants to buy a heart? Oh, yeah.
One broken lover's heart.
Ooh.
One broken heart for sale.
Ooh. Well, she would not listen to the things my heart was saying. She turned and walked away and told me I was playing. Some guys have all the luck, but my heart hasn't any. I think I'll paint a sign for sale for a penny.
Yeah. Who wants to buy a heart?
My poor heart.
One broken lover's heart.
Yeah.
One broken heart for sale.
Mm-hmm.
Who wants to buy a heart?
Oh, yeah.
One broken lover's heart.
One broken heart for sale.
Who wants to buy a heart?
My poor heart.
One broken lover's heart.
Oh, yeah.
One broken heart for sale. Who wants to buy a heart?
My poor heart.
One broken lover's heart.
Oh, yeah.
One broken heart.
I did many commercials with the quartet and without. Leo Burnett, he was a funny one. He didn't want any person to be his spokesperson. It had to be an animal. If you think back of Kellogg's, everything was an animal. He said, I'm coming out with a new cereal. It's Frosted Flakes. I want either Tony the Tiger, Elmer the Elephant, or Katie the Kangaroo to be the spokesperson. So Don spoke up, right? He says, I know just the guy who who would be good as Tony. So Leo said, well, send him a script, send him a drawing of Tony and a character description, and we'll see. I saw the script, and it said, always the payoff line was, well, Tony, are Sugar Frosted Flakes any good? Tony said, good, they're great. So I said, we got to do something with the word great to make it explode, you know. So I messed around, and I finally came up with a great, you know, and I'm still doing him.
Hi, I'm Tony the Tiger to tell about Kellogg's Sugar Frosted Flakes and their secret sugar frosting. Try some Frosted Flakes. They're great!
And I was invited back to Chicago for a big banquet with the Kellogg people. And I was happened to be seated at the table with the president of Kellogg's. The president said, Thurl, I don't know whether you know it or not, but he said, do you know that Frosted Flakes is the largest selling cereal in the entire world, and it's all your damn fault? Then I got a call to go out to Disney's. It was Cinderella. I was one of the singing mice in Cinderella, in falsetto, of course. And Walt was on every session, because he really had an interest, and he knew what was right and what was wrong. He knew what he wanted and what he didn't want. So he was on every session. And he took a liking to me. And every time he'd come up with something, he'd say, hey, let's see what Thurl will do with it. I opened Disneyland, my voice from the tower. Oh, I did so many things at Disneyland. The train that went around the park, and Bear Country Jamboree, you know, the buffalo head on the wall, and the Pirates of the Caribbean. I was many of the drunken pirates. In the Enchanted Tiki Room, I was the voice of the parrot. Earlier on, we did the Gillette commercials, my quartet, before Disney. I did a parrot there.
How are you fixed for Blake?
I'll take a look. By Jove, you know, I thought I had enough.
This worn-out blade will make you shaven mighty tough.
How are you fixed for Blake?
I'll go and get some.
Gillette's blue blades we need.
As far as the Haunted Mansion was concerned, Walt called my quartet out, and he said, you know, we're going to do a thing with the Haunted Mansion.
Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Haunted Mansion. I am your host, your ghost host. There's no turning back now. This chamber has no windows and no doors. Which offers you this chilling challenge: to find a way out. Of course, there's always my way.
So he said, I want you guys to sing a song which my music department will right. The grim, grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
When the crypt doors creak and the tombstones quake,
spooks and mockers wake and wake.
Happy haunts materialize
and begin to poke their lights. Grim, grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
Now don't close your eyes and don't try to hide.
Or a silly spook may sit by your side.
Shrouded in your dark disguise.
Socialize.
As the moon climbs high over the dead oak tree,
spooks arrive for the midnight free.
Creepy creeps with eerie eyes,
start to shriek and harmonize. Grim green ghosts come out to socialize.
When you hear the knell of a requiem bell,
we're closing our spirits well.
Restless bones etherealize,
rise as spooks of every size.
Doors creak and the tombstones quake.
Roots and mockers wane and wake.
Happy haunts materialize
and begin to poke their lights. Grim green ghosts come out to socialize.
Every Class B movie I've ever seen has a prison scene. And That's always a quartet in the background singing, "If I had the wings of an angel, over these prison walls I would fly," or "Home Sweet Home." Another thing, when Lady and the Tramp came out, Walt said, "Now, I'm going to make a picture about Lady and the Tramp." And he said, "We're going to be a prison scene, but it's going to be dogged. The dogs have to howl in four-part barbershop harmony, Home Sweet Home. Can you do it?" We said, "Well, all we can do is try, Walt." So we messed around. Walt was in the session. He said, "It sounds wonderful, guys, but still sounds like human beings howling like dogs." So he said, "Well," we said, "Walt, why don't you go up to your office and have lunch? We'll have lunch, and we'll work on it, and we'll call you back when we think we have something." So we stayed in the studio, and he went up to the office, and we messed with it and recorded various things. Finally, we said, "Hey, that sounded to us like real dog." So we called Walt down, and he sat in a big soundstage with three Voice of the Theater speakers around him and listened. And we played it. And Walt looked at Walt, and there were tears running down his cheek. He said, "Don't touch a thing. You did it." And that was typical of Walt. What he wanted, and he wasn't happy until he got it, but he knew it sounded like dogs howling. Working at Disneyland was such a joy, because you never knew what you're going to be called upon to do. Walt used to call us out, and he'd say, "Today, you guys, you're going to be wolves, or you're going to be coyotes, or you're going to be prairie dogs." And they had sent a crew out, you know, for maybe 2 years, and photographed these animals in their natural habitat. And then they edit that film down to just a certain amount of time. And we had to listen to in the earphones to these animals and imitate their sound to make it fit the picture of these animals. So we never knew what Walt was going to ask us to do. He knew we were flexible. He knew we weren't afraid to try anything. And we did the natural habitat of the wolves, the coyotes, the prairie dogs. I don't remember what else. But Walt was a sticker. They handed me The Grinch, and it had about 7 or 8 verses. So I knew, you know, I didn't have much time, and I better get it right or else. So we rehearsed it, and I took a look at the lyrics on the other verses, and they were okay. So I said, "Let's go one after the other, because we're getting a shorter time." I had another gig. So we recorded The Grinch, and we went in the control room with the writer and the animator, and listened to the playback, and they said, "What do you think, Thurl?" And I said, "Well, if you're happy, I'm happy, because it sounds good to me." And they said, "Well, okay, do the rest of the verses." And when it was over, Chuck turned to the writer, and he said, "That does it for me." He said, "What will we do next year for Christmas?"
"You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole. Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a
39 and a half foot pole. You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch. You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile, Mr. Grinch. Given the choice between the two of you, I'd take the seasick crocodile. You're a foul one, Mr. Grinch. You're a nasty, wasty skunk. Your heart is full of unwashed socks. Your soul is full of gunk, Mr. Grinch. The three words that best describe you are as follows, and I quote, stink, stank, stunk. You're a rotter, Mr. Grinch. You're the king of sinful sots. Your heart's a dead tomato splotch with moldy purple spots, Mr. Grinch. Your soul is an appalling dump heap, overflowing with the most disgraceful assortment of deplorable rubbish imaginable, mangled up in tangled up knots. You nauseate me, Mr. Grinch, with a nauseous super nos. You're a crooked jerky jockey and you drive a crooked hoss, Mr. Grinch. You're a three-decker sauerkraut and toadstool sandwich with arsenic sauce.
That's the story of how the Grinch stole Christmas.
And this is the story of the Headless Horseman.
Now gather round while I elucidate on what happens outside when it gets late. Along about midnight, the ghosts and banshees get together for their nightly jamborees. There's ghosts with horns and saucer eyes, and some with fangs about this size. Some short and fat, some tall and thin, and some don't even bother to wear their skin. I'm telling you, brother, it's a frightful sight to see what goes on in the night. Have a midnight jamboree. They break it up with fiendish glee. Ghosts are bad, but the one that's cursed is the Headless Horseman. He's the worst. When he goes a-jogging across the land, holding his noggin in his hand, demons take one look and groan and hit the road for parts unknown. There's no rack like the spook that's burned. They don't like him and he's really burned. Swears through the longest day he's dead. He'll show them that he can get ahead. Oh, close all the windows, lock the doors. Unless you're careful, he'll get yours. Don't think he'll hesitate a bit, cause he'll flip your top if it'll fit. And he likes some little, likes some big. Park in the middle or a wig, black or white or even red. The Headless Horseman needs a head with a hip, hip and a clippity clop. He's out looking for a head to chop, so don't stop to figure out a plan. You can't reason with a headless man.
Life's a celebration. Grand Event Rentals makes your event their top priority. They're your full-service, special event, and party rental provider, supplying everything you need from start to finish. Their professional sales team and event staff work with you to create your dream event. With every event, Grand Event Rentals' customers' needs are the most important. Whether you're planning an intimate outdoor wedding or an elaborate black tie gala, the Grand Event Rentals specialists make great pride in providing our event planning experience to help create an unforgettable event. Please go and visit the Bellevue Showroom, Grand Event Rentals, or make a one-on-one appointment talk to them. They're trained, they're knowledgeable, they're event specialists, and they are going to take you through step-by-step everything that you need to make your day a success. Call Grand Event Rentals. Their number is 425-462-7368, or go to grandeventrentalswa.com.
Lights, camera, action. Capture those precious moments at your special event with 1,000 Words Events friendly, fun party services. Make your guests smile with a unique photo booth. Bring the celebration anywhere with a green screen. Enhance the mood with event lighting or pile them in an awesome VW photo bus. Our services provide lasting memories and unique party favors. After all, a picture's worth 1,000 words. See for yourself what we do at 1000wordsevents.com or call us at 253-380-2026. Let's make some memories. Online at 1000wordsevents.com or 253-380-2026.
Dr. Amanda Wong and the team at Art of the Smiles provides comprehensive dental services at affordable prices. Their convenient location in Federal Way and their extended hours fits the needs of both families and working professionals. Whether it's transforming your smile through some of their cosmetic therapies or simply having your teeth cleaned, Art of the Smiles provides individualized care plans that address your priorities and needs. Visit artofthesmiles.com or call 253-839-4048. That's 253-839-4048 for same-day scheduling. Most insurances accepted, from cosmetic procedures to implant placement, molar root canals treatment, or wisdom teeth extractions.